That's not the answer. That's a lie.
Take it or leave it alone.
We want to know, right? Did Malcolm X apostatize and did he deny Elijah Muhammad? Did or did not Malcolm X deny that Elijah Muhammad? I've seen him in myself on the. I've seen it. Malcolm X. I've lifted the veil over that falsehood. I've exposed them talking about you, Elijah Muhammad.
You cannot be a Muslim unless you adhere to those principles. And so, sir, we adhere 100%. We have to get up in the morning and perform fajr. And before we go to bed at night, we gotta do issue. And right. So this is the reality of our existence.
Since he won't ask my questions, he knows that I know what I'm talking about.
We struggle with zakat, we struggle to go to Mecca and perform hajj. We struggle with
all. Ask him what's the first principle in Islam. The first one. Not salah, kafir, wasom. What's the first principle, my friend? The first principle. But I'm not your friend because I'm a devil. Sorry, I'm a blue, white, Caucasian, white devil. Yeah, the genuine question really is what's the first principle of Islam?
Principle of Islam.
Who is Allah?
The green jacket, right? You are so ignorant. The answer to the question. Can a Caucasian white man like this man in the green jacket, that's the person that was pointed out to me, can he be a Muslim? Any human being, regardless of speed or class or color, can be a Muslim.
That's right.
The criteria to be a Muslim.
But what you're saying,
to be a Muslim is that you submit your will entirely to do the will of God. He is my brother in faith. That is a Muslim. End the story.
Islam don't need bodyguard. Islam don't need bodyguard. If you are alright,
because
you nobody
the
you.
Black man in the Western Hemisphere has been through some unique.
Are you funny man from the television, Rhea McCoy?
And based on the unique circumstances that we have been through,
but you make people laugh. For
Allah, in His wisdom, not your wisdom.
That's right.
Allah's wisdom, because Allah is the best knower, not you.
That's right.
Allah, in His wisdom, has chosen to send one from among us to us to teach us about Islam and to bring us back into the Islamic family of true belief, whether you like it or not.
Right.
He gave us a specific message to the black man.
That's right.
That same
that's not
black
right.
man
is wrong, actually.
Muslims have been abused. That
right.
same black man that many of you saw at a time like this. What do you understand? Are you receiving your shot? That man that many in you, you sell alcohol to in your shop. That same black man. That any of you are racist against, and you have light-skinned Arabs, white people at the top of the Islamic Church, and you treat the black man as some inferior.
Ask them if they believe Allah manifested himself in the form of a man. And if they do, that Kafirs, we don't care if they pray, they fast, they read the Quran 100 times a day. Anyone who believes that God is a man, who became a man, he's a Kafir. And you believe in a prophet after Muhammad, you're a Kafir. The Quran says that Muhammad is the seal of the prophets. He's Khatam al-Nabi. So what's this message, my friend? Come on, tell us. Message to the black man. Of Elijah Muhammad. Do you believe he's a prophet or not?
We are called the lost, found members of the nation of Islam. The nation of Islam was set up in truth from the inception of Allah himself. Because Allah is where they stop. But the reality is that the nation of Islam, Allah says,
did you say Allah is a Muslim? You're stupid plunker. Allah is someone who submits to himself. You fool. Honestly, how stupid can you get? What more nonsense are you going to come out with? Tell them what Muslim means, Mr. Speaker. Please tell everyone here what Muslim means to show them what a foolish thing you've just said. What does the word Muslim mean? The word Muslim means someone who submits to Allah. So how can Allah be a Muslim? Well, Allah submits to Allah. Mind, mate. Really? The bunkers. You need to the black man, right?
Anybody member of the nation of Islam.
Yeah, but you can only get your mark on, right?
Submit to God.
The black man, that's all.
We have no doubt to say, like Caucasians.
And it's not right. You say Caucasians are devils.
That's right, these devils. That's right.
Blue-eyed devils, you've even got a verse of the Quran to prove it, haven't you? Blue-eyed devils, Caucasians, we've heard you quote it before. Why are you lying to everybody? That's what makes me sick. You're ashamed. You're lying because you're ashamed of the truth. That's right.
Have you chosen the broad way that leads to destruction?
But I've got green eyes. Where does that leave your interpretation of the Quranic verse? That's interesting. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله In the name of Allah The most compassionate, the most merciful, I testify and I bear witness that Allah alone is worthy of being worshipped and that Muhammad ibn Abdullah, who lived 1,400 years ago in Arabia, he is the slave of Allah and his messenger, and he is the last messenger. Every Muslim believes that Muhammad is the last prophet. As for those people who say that another man is a prophet after Muhammad, like the black people, nation of Islam, they call themselves, then there's no racism in Islam. The prophet Muhammad, the real prophet Muhammad, 1,400 years ago taught that there's no difference between the white man and the black man. There's no difference between the Arab and the non-Arab, except in one thing. The one thing is the degree to which you worship your Lord, you fear Him, and you obey him. Taqwa. That's the only difference between the people. Not the rich and the poor. Not the men and the women. Not the black and the white.